for a car that, you know, came out 40 years ago, it's still the most futuristic looking car there is. It looks like a spaceship.
Hey, so I know with Ready Player One and now with the release of Ready Player Two, your life's probably gone through a lot of change. Mine has too. You know, there was this time before, in the early days of Roblox, it was Eric and me, like two of us, just working on this thing, and then Matt and John joined us, and that was very different for me. You know, that was going in, writing code every day, quiet office. My life's completely different now, and now we have, you know, hundreds and hundreds of great people that all work together. How about you? Like, has your life changed?
My life has changed drastically. You know, when I was writing Ready Player One, I was working a tech support job. I was interested in technology, but I always wanted to be a writer, but I also was interested in computers, and working tech support was a way to, and helping people use computers, and also the job of being a tech support rep, that all worked its way into my novel, into Ready Player One, the way the main character works tech support in the Oasis for a while. And so that was something for my life that ended up informing the story. So even though I didn't enjoy that job at the time, and, you know, wished I was working somewhere else, now I'm grateful, that I had that job and that experience, because it worked its way into my story. It's like when I was a kid, we lived in a trailer park for a while, which was not fun. And my room was actually the tiny laundry room of the trailer, and it was just for a little while. But that was something that I put into Ready Player One. Wade sleeping in the laundry room of his trailer. And, yep. And the stacks and all of that came from this experience in my real life, and I, you know, saw it depicted in a Steven Spielberg movie. So that's something I always like to tell expiring writers about, is, you know.